kids, today we are going to see our first grammar chapter, nouns. So dear kids, as we know, noun is the name of person, place, animal and things. And in this chapter we are going to learn about common and proper nouns, collective nouns, countable and uncountable nouns, genders of the nouns and compound nouns. So let's get started. Common nouns. Common nouns are the names given to things, animals, places or people which are of the same kind. For example, girl, clock, cat, fish, all these are used for the same kind. Proper nouns. Yes, proper nouns are the names of particular person, places, animal and things. See the example, India, Mahatma Gandhi, Bruno, Himalaya, all these are proper nouns and all proper nouns begin with capital letters. Countable nouns. Yes, kids, countable nouns are those that we can count easily using numbers. Yes, see the four apples, five kids, seven cats. And uncountable nouns are those that we cannot count using numbers. Water, milk, sugar, oil, can we count these? No. But for uncountable noun, we use terms like a little, a lot of, for, or some to show quantity. And we can count like these, a glass of water or five glasses of water, three cartons of milk, some sugar, like that. Now collective nouns. Collective nouns, the word itself tells us that it is a collection. It is collective nouns are words for groups of people, animal or things. And collective nouns are always treated as singular nouns. So that we can say the flowers are pretty, here flowers are many. So we use plural verb. But the bouquet of flowers is pretty. Here flowers are many, but the bouquet is one only. Bouquet is collective noun. So here we use singular verb. The same way the keys are missing, but the bunch of keys is missing. See more collective nouns, group of islands, a class of students, a school of fish, an army of ants, galaxy of stars, a forest of trees. Now let us see gender of the nouns. There are four kind of genders, masculine, feminine, common and neuter. So kids, a noun that stands for a male living being is said to be masculine gender. Yes. So, boy, father, king, dog, lion, all these are nouns used for a masculine gender. And a noun that stands for female living being is said to be the feminine gender. So, girl, mother, queen, bitch, lioness, all these are of feminine gender. Now, neuter gender. A noun that signifies non-living or lifeless thing is said to be the neuter gender. So, sun, bus, ball, bag, doll, tractor, windmill, all these are of neuter gender. Now common gender. So always remember, a noun that signifies both male and female is said to be the common gender. See the example, lawyer. Lawyer may be male also and may be female also. The same way parents, singers, children, doctors, all these are male also and female also. So it is common gender. Compound noun. Yes, nouns that are formed by putting together two words are called compound words, like policeman, blueberry, battlefield, etc. Police and man makes one word policeman. Two words blue and berry makes one word blueberry. Compound nouns that consist of two or more words. See the example: football, foot plus ball, tablecloth, table plus cloth, bedroom, bed plus room, toothpaste, tooth plus paste. So, dear kids, all these are about nouns. I hope you understand nouns nicely. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you. Bye-bye.